Video News. It's KP Video News, yo. It's KP's Video News, yo.
That's right, it's KP's Video News, y'all. And this is, I'm doing these stories here because it's something that I had been talking with someone about a couple of weeks ago, and I was telling them how when I was a kid, my mom discovered that it was something that about certain doctors that I didn't like. And so she started looking around, and she discovered some black doctors, and I was living in the south side of Chicago. And at that time, it was a wealth of black professionals, doctors, lawyers, dentists, you know, you name it, black business owners. I mean, they were everywhere. And so at that point, you know, she got me a black pediatrician, and I had a black dentist and all that stuff. And she noticed I was more comfortable with them. And but now I have to do this story today, and it says, where are all the black male doctors? Why are they so scarce in America? And the fact that black males comprise only 3.1% of medical school enrollment back in 78 and 79 school year, according to the Association of American Medical Colleges, probably isn't that alarming. After all, it was 1978, Jimmy Carter was president, Dallas and Greece had just been released, and the shocking and demoralizing realization, though it is comparable start in the stat for 2019 and 2020 year, is actually lower at 2.9%, or nearly unchanged at 3.4% for the alone or in combination statistic that includes those identifying with another race as well. How could it be that over the past 40 years, with all the progress on issues of racial inequality and injustice, that the number is actually worse now than it was then? So the numbers of black doctors, black male doctors today, is actually worse than it was back in 78. Indeed, for those who felt like the election of a black president was a clear proof that America had moved on beyond racism, this single sobering statistic is just one of many to the contrary. And NPR analyzed this issue in the 2015 issue article. There were fewer black men in the medical school in 2014 than in 1978. While the numbers for African Americans are dismal overall, the black men, they're particularly tragic. Indeed, the data shows that the percentage of enrollment for African American women actually increased from only 2.2% during the 1978 school year to 4.4% during the 2019 school year, and 5.2% considering those identifying as black. This begs the question, over the past 40 years, why haven't the numbers gotten significantly better for black men? And this is precisely the question tackled in the 2015 report, Altering the Course, Black Males in Medicine. While some may push back on the concept of systematic racism, instead preferring to see inequalities as one of aberrations or a result of individual failings, the dearth of black male doctors in America is arguably a great example of the predictable results of systematic widespread racism. Arguably, the specific root cause factors are many, all tinged by the reality of racism's grip on many facets of society, including inequities in education, household income, the judicial system, community resources, and many other factors. And so we had Dr. Mark Nevitt insist. He said he think the primary problems for black males in pursuing medicine or any professional career is racism and bias, but it does not take the form we traditionally think of, such as closed doors or signs that say blacks not allowed. Just recently, the National Medical Association, the leading voice for African American physicians, announced an action collaborative on Black Men in Medicine. Their joint statement clearly ties the decades-long problems of Black male underrepresentation in medicine to systematic racism. The root cause is systematic racism dating back to chattel slavery. And this is a societal issue that will require cross-sector investment and collaboration to memory and the remedy. While no single article can significantly analyze the myriad of ways that systematic racism impacts the number of Black men in medicine, let's explore a range of explicit barriers and challenges that it creates. Educational disparities, arguably the challenge that Black men face pursuing a career in medicine, are rooted in disparities and challenges faced by Black men in life, starting in the classroom. America is failing its young Black boys in metropolitan ghettos, rural villages, and mid-sized townships and across the country. Schools have become holding tanks for populations of Black boys who have statistically higher probability of walking the corridors of prison than the halls of a college. And we fail our Black sons more than any other racial or ethnic group. Among the educational related barriers and challenges altering the course, Black males in medicine cites the following disadvantages of Black male youth: and a higher likelihood of being educated in schools with fewer resources, lower levels of participation in gifted or magnet programs, lower rates of participation in AP courses, and lower participation rates in STEM courses, higher instances of suspensions or disciplinary action that suggests that contributing factors to this may include lack of cultural awareness among the teachers. While numerous statistics point to a stark achievement gap, a senior director, Norman Hunter, rejects the notion that the students are somehow less able. If not the students that are, it's not the students that are the problem, not the young Black boys or Black men, it's the system and how the systems treat them along the way. Indeed, Dr. Nivett also cites George Bush's phrase, the soft bigotry of low expectations, as a major factory that starts as early as kindergarten and continues through the academic career. The systematic issues build on each other over time and create a disadvantage that even the best students can't overcome, because the reality is that the system has embedded within it these biases and often determined that looks, what talent looks like and where talent should come from. And so then the next stumbling block is the significant medical school costs, with medical students carrying an average student loan debt of $200,000, according to the AAMC. Medical school simply isn't feasible for many Black students who are typically coming from significantly less advantaged households. And in fact, the Brookings Institute analysis of Black and white wealth gap finds that the net worth of the average Black family is about 10% of what the average white family. Without strong family support, the reality of medical school is often a mere pipe dream for even the best Black students. The third stumbling block, few Black males, role models, and a weak support system. The scarcity of Black males and doctors also translates into fewer role models for young Black men. So there's no Black male doctors for them to see, so there's no Black role models for them to see for the young Black men. It's hard to be what you don't see, and there are too few minority doctors to begin with, but especially Black male physicians. With fewer Black physicians in the Black community, indeed, young Black youth often don't have a strong and extended support network to help socialize them to the pre-med process or just provide moral support and encouragement. The dearth of Black men in medical school also creates an added pressure once in medical school, as they can often feel isolated and internalize added pressure to perform well. In my medical school class, I was only one of two Black men, and one doctor stated, and medical school is a grueling experience without the added pressure of being Black while training, and you're the only one there. And then you have the next bias, and it's the bias perceptions of Black men. Black men also face the daunting perception problem. Racism fuels bias and stereotyping that often creates significant barriers that follow them throughout their career. The report concludes the most commonly noted challenge is the bias and stereotyping related to the black male experience in the United States. Negative perceptions of black males in the media and throughout society don't just create bias that impacts teachers, career advisors, admissions counselors, and other influencers, but these perceptions can poison how they view themselves and their potential. Unfortunately for black males who do succeed in attaining their medical degree despite the odds, these negative perception issues often persist. Despite my extensive training and prestigious education experience, my credibility is often questioned when I walk into the classroom, boardrooms, operating rooms. We're often first seen by the color of our skin and are only later recognized by our degrees and successes. Indeed, there are many accounts of patients refusing care from black doctors. This puts these physicians in conflicting positions and limits meaningful educational experiences of our nation's rising generation of medical professionals. And then you have the added social responsibility. Black medical students and physicians often bear the added burden of working to disprove negative stereotypes and ultimately uplift the entire race. While my classmates were able to focus on studying, I constantly balanced studying with working to create a pipeline of minority physicians and to maintain an environment of inclusion. And ironically, instead of reveling in their significant professional accomplishment, black physicians often continue to feel they need to prove themselves. This ever-present need to prove my worthiness that started as an undergraduate continues almost 30 years later as a physician's leader. And indeed, my success or failure in a position would be a difference between a doctor opening door being open or closed for the next black physician leader. And what's the impact? And the impact is the lack of diversity in healthcare creates far-reaching consequences. Arguably, the most significant negative impact is on health outcomes for black Americans. Studies demonstrate that African Americans can have better outcomes when treated by black doctors. Among the reasons contributing to the phenomenon is the low trust between black Americans and the American healthcare system. Many black Americans have a long-standing history of skepticism in the American healthcare system due to decades of harmful experiments and misuse of medical research, including the Tuskegee syphilis experiment and the exploitation of Henrietta Lacks Sales, explained Dr. Hildreth. This enduring lack of trust in healthcare impacts preventative care, further contributing to the many health disparities seen today throughout the black community. In recent months, it has been clear that people of color have been disproportionately represented in COVID-19 deaths. Possibly black physicians were the least surprised. The COVID-19 pandemic has highlighted the racial disparities that exist between healthcare, insists that black communities often have fewer resources and less access to healthcare, but there are also fewer physicians in those communities who can truly connect with those patients. Unfortunately, similar health disparities around this in various areas of medicine. Perhaps the most tragic consequence of having so few black male physicians is the perception of the cycle. Indeed, the result becomes the cause and the system continues. So we got to do what we got to do, get our kids and grandkids involved, our young boys and girls and our daughters and granddaughters and nieces involved. We need more black people in the medical field. We need them because these are the people that are going to go the extra mile to help you, that are going to go the extra mile to make sure that you get the best medical care that you can possibly get. So this is just a necessity. It's time to get back on it.
Hey, please, video news.
Peace.